you can't do 100 kids. You know, you cut the cast to 60, but then I would always say to Damaris and Beth and Evelyn and all my old candor, my mainstays that have been with me for years, I feel horrible for those 40 kids that got the cut. So what we developed was a class called Main Kids Junior, which is not audition-based, that anybody that signs up gets a role and learns. So I love this class. I love the class because I personally love teaching beginners. If any of you parents have sat in here with me, you go home and go, he's nuts, how do you do it? It's crazy. So, but I actually do love this age group, and I do love the excitement of seeing a kid being on stage for the first time and doing things for the first time. It's gratifying and cool for me. I have my first group of Main Stage junior kids going into really good colleges right now, so I've seen it come and go. You know, yeah. Now my stump speech is we have 6 kids on Broadway right now. In our history, 15 have made it to Broadway. We have 6 right now, which is crazy. I'm not going to say that any of them did Main Stage Junior, but I know 2 of the 6, Tot was a counselor to Main Stage Junior. What you're going to see tonight is not perfect. Front up. We have lots of bodies. We have 40 in the cast, which is really big for Main Stage Junior. And it's hard to teach it because they get out of school at 4:30 and they're so wound up. They're so crazy wound up. But it's okay. It's okay. I think we've done a pretty good job. They have learned well, and they've done a good job. So, you know, it's not perfection, but I think they're really good. I'm very, very proud of them. That's the last thing to say. So here's the deal. We're going to run the show. Of course, there's no intermission. And when the show's over, look at their company bow, and then they're going to come out here. And you guys can take pictures. Okay? Sounds good? Okay. All right.
George Washington, that he made all his own royal soldiers. dressed in bright red uniforms that blah, 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 blah. Marionettes have special powers. They can sit and talk to me for hours. And I'm lonely. And of course, these bright red uniforms made them look just like giant walking dolls.
Alice, honestly, when are you ever going to grow up?
Look, Matilda, I'm a lion. Roar!
Alice, you're not a lion. You're a silly little girl, and you're going to meet lots of strange people in the world.
Singing flowers. Painting cards. And even a talking Cheshire cat. Oh wait, that's me. Alice's journey begins with a pallid, long-eared, carrot-munching quadruped known only as the White Rabbit. I said, Alice's journey begins with the White Rabbit. He's always late. Yo, White Rabbit, you're on. My rabbit? Rabbit to the edge of the rabbit hole.
Should I or shouldn't I? You know what they say, if you never explore, then you never learn. But what my sister Matilda always says, look before you leap. Well, I'm looking, and it looks pretty deep and dark, and I might even fall all the way down to the center of the Earth's core and be bent and be burnt to a crisp like a bad marshmallow we've all heard so much about. Or not. Okay, I looked. Now it's time to leap.
Alice fell and fell and fell. She fell for what seemed like 3.5 weeks. Finally, she made it to the end of the rabbit hole. Oh, flowers, bring me a script. Thank you. You're not on yet. You're in the next scene. Let's try this again. She fell and fell and fell.
I'm too big to enter this door.
Thank you. Here, hold on a second. I have a potion. Drink this.
Oh, look at me. I'm the right size for that door.
I believe someone's forgetting about the key way up there on that shelf.
Now I'm too small to reach the key.
Don't fret. Here, try a cookie.
Here you are.
Doesn't matter if I'm tall, big, or small, I never seem to fit.
Well, that's tough. Try Pittsburgh.
Yeah, you're way too big to fit in this door. You gotta try Pittsburgh.
Great place.
What can I do?
Poor Alice was so sad, she started crying. She cried and cried and cried until...
I am monarch of the sea, the ruler of the Queen's Navy.
I'm all wet. I'll never get to Wonderland now. What can I do?
Everybody take your place before we start the monarch's race. When you hear the snares and cough, they're off.
And you'll be whispered, yeah. Say hi if you
you do?
Make her way to a beautiful cottage. It was indeed the White Rabbit's cottage.
I'm too big to enter this cottage.
Flowers! Flowers? Hello? A nice little cup of potion. Guess. And you'll fit in quite nicely. Sorry, folks. Technical issues. Anyways, let's continue with our show. So, where were we? Alice made her way to the cottage, but then she decided to go to the secret garden.
A walk, 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 a walk
you think it's crazy? I was so excited to visit Wonderland, but now I think it's absolutely
bonkers, crazy, out of control, mayhem.
All of the above. I don't know what's coming or going.
You need to talk to the Mad Hatter. The Mad Hatter knows everything. He keeps it all under his hat.
A Mad Hatter? I don't want to make anyone mad.
Haven't you noticed? Everybody's mad. Everybody's a little bit mad. Enjoy the tea party.
She needed to find her way. Right, Alice?
Yeah.
But the only problem is, in Wonderland, there's only the Queen's way.
But I've never met a queen.
Well, then today's the day! You're gonna meet the biggest queen of all. Right this way to the Royal Rose Garden. Rosie, you're on deck. Right this way, Alice.
Simon says, to me.
Okay.
Oh, is the poor little child out of words?
No.
Well, I see here. You are not from Wonderland. You do not know the rules here.
I don't, but I like it here. And I think I'm pretty good at Simon Says.
Off with your head! What did you just say to me?
Starting with Logan, he comes to the front of the stage, and Harrison.